Riding a motorcycle across the country isn't for everybody, but if you do it one time and you like it, you're hooked for life. I got my first bike 20 years ago, and since then I've logged over 400,000 miles through all the lower 48 states of the United States and most of Canada. But no matter how well I plan a ride, I can count on things changing. I get a great feeling of anticipation, a great feeling of excitement, but there's also a bit of foreboding. You never know what's going to happen. The weather might get you, you might break down, you might go down hard and not make it home, but it's all part of the adventure.
I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
I've ridden my bike through all the places you just heard about in that song and through thousands of other towns. But there's something special about Route 66. It's not just me. Ask anybody who's ridden across the country and they're going to tell you they'd rather be on a motorcycle than in a car. And if they've been on Route 66, they're going to tell you they can't wait to get back there.
The biggest changes that I've seen on Route 66 is people getting reinvigorated about restoring and using and traveling up and down Route 66. Well, I like doing everything better on a motorcycle than a car, because you're out in the wind and you're traveling down the open road. Back in the day when they made the movie Easy Rider, they went down parts of Route 66. So it's neat to go down those historic places that are gone now. Go see the sights that they saw. I'm a Route 66 fan, so it's all great to me.
What made me want to get a motorcycle? Just the freedom, being able to go and do and become one with nature and one with the bike. There's nothing like it. I just enjoy riding my motorcycle. It's the biggest stress relief that I have right now, just to get out and go and just take off. And I hope to inspire many more women.
If you haven't been on Route 66 and you want to go on it, you just need to go out there and start anywhere at any time and see it. There's plenty of books. Sam Allen's got the excellent Motorcycle Party Guide book to capture the thrills, the places to go, the scenery. You just need to go out and see Route 66.
After doing that trip along Route 66, Route 66 has got into my soul, sort of, and what's disappointing to me is the fact that I live so far away from Route 66. It's not, I can't just hop in a car or on a bike and get here without spending 4 or 5 days to do it. So I've kept in touch on Facebook in particular with a lot of the people along the route, and it sort of makes me feel a part of it, and I hope to continue that.
Do yourself a favor and get your own kicks on Route 66, and by God, do it on a motorcycle.
Took a look down a westbound road, right away I made my choice. Headed out to my big two-wheeler, I was tired of my own voice.